Hello and welcome to my creating room. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and I want to take you behind the scenes on one of my images that is a really, really labor-intensive image. I typically spend anywhere from 2 to 4 hours on the average edit. For more complicated edits, I typically spend more like 10 to 15 hours, but for this edit, I spent more like 30 hours on it. And the reason was because I was building it from the ground up. And so what you're going to see is that the original image was only a tiny fraction of the final canvas that I ended up building. So it took a lot of layering, a lot of manipulating of the images, and then on top of that, I had to make an entire dress out of books. And it was not easy. So let me take you behind the scenes of this picture. This is called the research laboratory, and we've got the finished image here, and as you can see, this was so long ago that I don't have all the layers for it, but I saved it in two parts. So here's the original, and let's just go down to see. You see this frame right here? That was the whole image. Like, that was the resolution of one picture for me at that time. And I went into this knowing that I wanted to shoot it in many, many parts because the resolution of my camera at that time wasn't great enough that I could easily print really big. And I wanted to print really big. I wanted this to be a showpiece, like really a standout image. And so I shot really close to my subject and shot lots of pieces of her. So first her head and her torso and then her legs and her arms and each a different piece so that I could piece it together. And that did allow me to print very large. This is a massive image when it's all said and done. In fact, if I look at the image size, I can see that it's over 13,000 pixels, which translates to about 45 inches at its natural size without it being stretched. So we have a really big image here. So let's go see. This was the first image that we made. Just that little tiny one, and you'll see I got a different eye in there, just something a little bit bigger from a different picture from the eyeglass, and then you'll start to see other images get added in. So here's her body coming together in pieces, and then the surrounding area in pieces, wherever I could. And I remember there were certain spots that I missed, because when you're going through a process like this, it is so difficult to take enough shots to really have the patience to just shoot, 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 and make sure you scan the whole area and get everything. So I definitely missed some places here. You can see the whole left side, I didn't go far enough. But the amazing thing about this technique is that the background is super out of focus because I shot really close to my subject. So when I zoom in, like, you can see how blurry that background is. So she has natural separation in an area where she might not at all, because I don't use lights. So there's no light naturally separating her. And I don't use any super special lens to create that separation either. So for me, it's all about getting as close as I can to the subject and making the background fall out of focus. So this was the image as far as I took it for this part of the edit. And then we sort of skipped to here, which seems really odd and is kind of frustrating that I didn't save my layers at the time of editing this. But I'll tell you why, because when I was editing this, I actually didn't understand that you could save large Photoshop files, or in other words, PSB files. So I ended up flattening my image and making a separate canvas and saving that as part two so that I could save a PSD. I just didn't know. So we're left without the stages of the book pages. But I'll tell you what I did. I took the book pages, the books themselves, and I held them at all different angles. So my friend here held them up at all different angles, all over the place, and I photographed them one by one, all in a different position. Up, down, toward the camera, further from the camera, and then I started to put them into this image. So if we look here, we can see that this is made of many different books all layered together, and then I had to create shadows from the book that was on top onto the book below it, and so on. Keeping in mind that they were backlit, the light was coming from here, as it shows in this picture, hitting our subject like a rim light, and same here. So certain books had to be lighter than others, and that's how I did it. So lots and lots of cutting the book out, pasting it in, making sure everything was cut out appropriately, and then creating shadows and form to make the dress, which was challenging, and that's why it took me so long. I could definitely do something like this a lot faster today, but it took a lot of time to learn. I'm sure that we can all relate. I'm sure that you've created something that just took you so long, but now maybe you could do it a lot faster. So maybe you try something like this where you shoot really close to something and then start to expand the frame, or maybe you just do something that you've never done before, because maybe today is the day that you work through how something gets finished, and then in the future you can do it faster. So whatever you're up to this week, I hope you have a magnificent time doing it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.